official VI. Put up your hand them high. Proud that you from the VI. Wave your flags up in the sky. Show them we run this.
This is Calvert White, the commissioner for the Department of Sports, Park and Recreation. And as you can see, we are now in day three of the rebuild of the Midre Cummings Playground facility. First off, I want to thank all the volunteers and the private businesses that has contributed to this project. Hundreds and hundreds of people have came out in swarms to contribute to the community. This is a community-built project that the community is going to feel so proud when they're finished, because they're going to look at what they was able to contribute in this project. Obviously, we've had people from all over this island come in and chipped in any way they can, in-kind donations, giving their time, effort, and sweat so that we can rehabilitate the Midre Cummings. It's 3 days in, we still have another 5 days to go. This project is slated to be completed on Saturday, November 20th. We are sticking to that timeline. We had some hiccups in the beginning, but we're back on track. So I'm still encouraging all of you, if you sound of my voice and you can come down and chip in and lend, please come out and be part of this wonderful project.
Yes, we members are General Jones, and we have tried to be part of the community, and we do things to assist in a community. And we are known for partying, but when we get serious, we get serious. And we've been here from earlier, and looking forward to come back again before this project is finished to do some work.
All right. How was the experience? How was the work?
Oh, it was great. You know, when the community come together, you know, all sector life come together, it's beautiful. I could remember this park, you know, I lived down here one time, and my kids were young, and I had them here in the park. And so my grandkids were coming, looking forward to come here. My kids are older now, so they bring their children down here like I did, brought their down here. All right, and that's one of our project that we accomplished over there. Is one of the tops that will be placed on top here, and we you know, looking forward to see it done, and we are proud of our work. My name is Roy Rogers. I've been in German June for pretty near 40 years. And I love the organization, the younger guys. We bring in guys on a regular basis.
Okay, my name is Hugh Clark, and I'm a team leader down here in Fredericksted at the park. And these guys recruited me last minute, and from the last minute they recruit me, I've been here every single day from 6 o'clock in the morning till 8:30 in the night. I would like to encourage all the men out there to come and give us a hand. This is for the children of the Virgin Islands. This is a serious thing. This, nothing like this have never happened in the Virgin Islands, where Christiansted, Fredericksted, Wim, Suffolk Raleigh, everybody, the Santos, the Puerto Ricans, the Dominicans, everybody is here helping out. So you guys need to come out. I'm a team leader, you come down here. Even if you know to use a drill or a hammer, there's something here for you to do to help this process.
Bless and love and respect in the greetings of your Imperial Majesty Elia Selassie. This is Edmund Felto from Akibeka Band Midnight Band. Just encouraging everybody out here to come out and help. Just as I did, everybody come out and volunteer. It would be a lovely thing for everybody's children, for the future, for your children, a place for you. Blessed love and respect. That's how far I live.
And, thank you always to all of TV for always covering important community events. Good evening to all. I'm Senator Genevieve Whitaker, and this is a really momentous occasion. I've been with the project in terms of, you know, from the beginning when they held the town hall meetings, first at on the Door Center, and to see where it is today now is really incredible. All the volunteers coming out, I brought out my staff members as well, and to see everyone, my colleagues with the Third Full Legislature, we all, you know, really came together to support this. And so why do I think it's important? This is so important that here in our historic town of Fredericksted, that we're going to see a piece of history in many ways, a rebuilding of a really important park, what Midre Cummings means to the community. Again, this is a one way of showing the town of Fredericksted as we look to restore and revitalize the town, and a place now where our children can play from throughout the island, and also a place where we can, in the future, see ways in which, you know, families come together to enjoy themselves. My own son, he comes out here, and other children, growing, you know, on the younger child, and it'll be it's a great thing. So I am really excited. I'm looking forward to the park. My biggest thing as a center of oversight is it being maintained, and making sure that we are supporting it in the future. To Commissioner White and his team at the Department of Sports and Park and Recreation, kudos to you as well. And again, thank you, and kudos to OTV. We've always covering important community events. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Willard John. Christina McPherson, who envisioned this whole project, is a friend of mine, and she approached me to assist her. So I was in on this deal from its conception. And this project is so significant for St. Croix and for Fredericksted. The most valuable part of this project, I think, is that it is a community build. So we bring this company that designed these units for children to play in, and the labor is free. That means the community comes out and provides the labor to make this happen. And you know what's going to happen? 2 weeks, 2 months, 2 years, 20 years from now, people are going to walk by and say, I was a part of this build. I helped them put this together. So this is our project. And who's going to benefit from it? It's the children of St. Croix, and particularly the residents in Fredericksted. But rest assured, people from all over the island, and probably St. Thomas and afar, will come and participate in the activities that are here to offer for the children of the Virgin Islands. So I'm very happy and very proud to be a part of this project. And I know we're all going to be proud of it. Thank you.
My name is Sean. I'm one of the crew leads on this project. So that means I'm working full time during the build, morning, afternoon, and evening, to help organize the teams and just get everything in the ground and up and running. It's a lot of fun. It's been amazing so far. The turnout has been great. I've actually been involved with this project since the idea started like 8 or 9 months ago with my wife Christina and Willard and Ronnie and Claire and a few other folks. And since then, it's been amazing how it's just taken off and the energy everybody's brought to it. And, you know, if you look around right now and see what's going up, it's amazing. So, you know, I hope everybody's coming out, and look forward to seeing you.
So the unique thing about this project is we have a playground section for the older kids. We have something for the younger kids that's going to be over here. We even have a fitness park all the way on the end that you can go there and do some exercise and whatnot. Once again, I want to thank all the volunteers and the businesses that have been coming out and donated. And keep in mind, there is still some shifts open that you can participate and be part of this wonderful project. If you want to be a part of it, just contact Linda, and we'll get you on the sheet so that you can be part of this wonderful project.
Well, good evening. Tomorrow, to help us build Midre Cummings Park.
Remember, with it being a community event, you can have your name engraved in this project. For just $100, you can have your name, family name, your children name, your parents' name engraved on one of our picket fence. It's something that would last a lifetime and just show that you was part of this project.
Great news! St. Thomas now has its own Galvalume factory. VI Galvalume factory, located at Four Winds Plaza behind the dry cleaners. The only Galvalume provider in St. Thomas with DPNR required 24 gauge material. Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. VI Galvalume.
been together for some time now, soon to be married. I think we're ready for a family of our own.
I knew that when I proposed that she'd be ready for us to have a child, but knowing that I carry the sickle cell trait, I may have a few questions that I need answered first.
Sickle cell disease is an inherited red blood cell disorder in which the red blood cells are abnormal. As a result, there aren't enough healthy red blood cells to carry oxygen throughout the body. Having sickle cell disease doesn't mean it's the end. Learn ways to manage your sickle cell disease. First, know your status by getting tested. Do you carry the sickle cell trait or genes? If you do, then follow the regimen advised by your clinical professional and practice a healthy lifestyle. You can live well as a sickle cell patient.
We were nervous at first, but now knowing our status, carrier and non-carrier,
now we can finally have a family of our own.
Sickle cell didn't stop us.
And it shouldn't stop you.